Okay, students. Yesterday we reviewed the expressing doubts, and we have some expressions in English about the doubts. Tenemos algunas expresiones en inglés que se utilizan para decir que usted duda de algo, ¿no es cierto? Bueno, esto tendríamos que haber escrito en el cuaderno. Now, today we are going to review the language practice exercises. So please open your books in the page 115. Abra por favor entonces el libro en la página 115 y tenemos los ejercicios de language practice. Okay, let's do it. Listen to the dialogue, decide if the statement is true or false. Escuche el diálogo, decida si la oración es verdadera o falsa. Okay, we have 8 sentences. About the pair, Paul tells Adam to, ¿no? Lo que le dice Paul a Adam. Y pues nosotros debemos elegir si es que estas oraciones son verdaderas o falsas. ¿Listo? Primero vamos a leer. Martín Palma, please, can you read the first sentence?
Write down his.
Thank you. Number two, Junior Escobar.
Be more practical about his job choosing.
Number three, Odalis Carrera.
Be a time traveler.
Thank you. Be a time traveler. Viajero del tiempo, ¿no es cierto? Ricardo Arcos. Number four.
Join the Air Force.
Thank you. Number five, Malena Lobato.
Study hard.
Study hard. Alejandra Trujillo, number six.
Build his own spaceships.
Build his own spaceships, ¿no? Sus naves espaciales. Number seven, Adriana. Please. Adriana.
Learn about NASA space shuttles.
Thank you. Anaí, number eight.
Get information about the space travel.
Thank you. Get information about the space travel. So please pay attention with the audio. And start now.
I want to find a job. Do you have any suggestions?
Well, first you should write down what kinds of jobs you would like.
Yeah, I'm thinking I want to work as a pilot, an astronaut, a time traveler, or a dinosaur.
Dinosaur? I suggest that you be a bit more realistic.
Oh, okay. So you'd advise me to be a time traveler then?
No. How about joining the Air Force first? They'll train you to be a pilot.
Yeah, then I could fly all day long. I could always become an astronaut afterwards.
You'd better study hard if you want to be an astronaut. It's not easy to get in.
Maybe I should build my own spaceship. That would be easier.
I don't think so. Why not visit NASA and see how its spaceships work?
I think I'm going to start now.
It might be a good idea to go to the Space Museum to learn more about your dream job.
Okay, students. Do you need to listen again? One more time.
Yes, please.
Ya, a ver, espere, le busco solo el audio. Language practice.
I want to find a job. Do you have any suggestions?
Well, First, you should write down what kinds of jobs you would like.
Yeah, I'm thinking I want to work as a pilot, an astronaut, a time traveler, or a dinosaur.
Dinosaur? I suggest that you be a bit more realistic.
Oh, okay. So you'd advise me to be a time traveler then?
No. How about joining the Air Force first? They'll train you to be a pilot.
Yeah. Then I could fly all day long. I could always become an astronaut afterwards.
You'd better study hard if you want to be an astronaut. It's not easy to get in.
Maybe I should build my own spaceship. That would be easier.
I don't think so. Why not visit NASA and see how its spaceships work?
I think I'm going to start now.
It might be a good idea to go to the Space Museum to learn more about your dream job.
We continue with the participations. Alejandra Trujillo. Paul tells Adam to write down his top jobs. True or false?
False.
That is true. Now, bueno, les voy a nombrar.
Yo les dije.
Estoy viendo en el orden de aquí de la de lo que les tengo aquí en la pantalla, ¿ya? Anaí Paguay, number two, be more practical about his job choice.
False.
True. Excellent. Dylan Herrera, number three, be a time traveler. True or false?
True.
Le dice que sea un astro, un viajante del tiempo. Está seguro. That is false. Number four, Nicolás Chávez, join the Air Force. True or false?
False.
That is true. Odalis Carrera, number five, study hard. True or false?
True.
Muy bien, true. Martín Palma, number six. True or false?
False.
Muy bien, false. Michael Garzón, number seven, learn about NASA's space shuttles. True or false?
True.
That is true, thank you. Albuja Sebastián, number eight, get information about space travel. True or false?
True.
True. Excellent. Thank you, students. That is the correct answers. Now, let there be multiple choice. Listen to the audio and circle the answer. Escuche el audio y encierre en un círculo las respuestas. La primera pregunta es, Natalia Favara, please read the first question.
What do you not need to worry about?
What do you not need to worry about? Number two, Anaí Carrera.
Why do you have to be careful on vacation?
Number three, Melanie Salgado.
Why might you see a doctor before?
Why might you see a doctor before a trip? ¿Por qué deberías, por qué podrías tú ver al doctor antes de un viaje? Y bueno, ahí tiene cuatro opciones, ¿no? En cada una de estas preguntas. Finally, number four, Tatiana Bonilla, please.
What is the main point of the recording?
Excellent. What is the main point of the recording? Ya, lea por favor rápidamente las opciones que tiene ahí para cada una de las preguntas. That's right. So please pay attention to the audio.
Traveling abroad can be amazing. It can open your eyes to... traveling abroad can be amazing. It can open your eyes to different cultures and ways of life. There are, however, a few things to watch out for. The first thing you need to pay attention to is that you are prepared. Have your passport, your ticket, your insurance, and your visa ready. Get any medication you need from your doctor to keep yourself healthy. Secondly, when you travel, beware of thieves. They're always looking for tourists. Keep your valuable items close to you at all times. Don't dress too expensively and look out for suspicious strangers. Also, if you have any problems with your passport or visa, just contact your local embassy. As long as you are careful and keep your eyes open for danger, you will have a great holiday and peace of mind.
Okay, for the number one, what do you not need to worry about? ¿Por qué no necesitas tú preocuparte?
The embassy.
The embassy. The embassy, muy bien. Por la embajada. Number two, why do you have to be careful on vacation? ¿Por qué debes tener cuidado en vacaciones? Tiene cuatro opciones. You might have problems with your clothes. Puedes tener problemas con tu ropa. Somebody may contact your embassy. You might need to see a doctor abroad. Somebody might take your things.
Sí. Sí.
Letter C. No. Letter D. Somebody might take your things. Alguien podría tomar tus cosas. Number three. Why might you see a doctor before a trip? ¿Por qué deberías ver un doctor antes del viaje? Letter A, you might need some medicine. Podrías necesitar algo de medicina. Letter B, he can explain new cultures to you. Te podrá explicar cosas de nuevas culturas. Letter C, a doctor will give you a visa. Un doctor te podrá dar una visa. Or letter D, you will probably have an injury. Tú probablemente tendrás un accidente, ¿no? Un lastimado, o sea, una herida. What is the correct answer?
Hey.
You might need some medicine. Podrías necesitar algo de medicina. Number four. What is the main point of the recording? ¿Cuál es el punto principal de la grabación? Thieves are everywhere. Ladrones hay en todos lados. You should take care when you travel. Deberías tener cuidado cuando tú viajes. People need to watch out for tourists. La gente necesita vigilar a los turistas. And number, letter D, embassies are great places to visit. Embajadas son grandes lugares para visitar. What is the correct answer? No.
Letter A.
No. Letter B. You should take care. No. Deberías tener cuidado cuando tú viajes. Finally, we are in the letter C. Fill in the blanks. Listen to the dialogue. Complete the sentence with the word you hear. Tenemos de igual manera que escuchar el audio para completar esta. Para completar entonces este ejercicio, ¿sí? A ver qué pasó. Ok, vamos a leer las oraciones primero. Bueno, como ya solemos hacerlo. Ahora empecemos desde acá abajo. Axel Carrillo, please read the first sentence without the option, sin la respuesta, va a leer entonces la primera oración. Axel Carrillo. ¿No está? Chao. Jean-Pierre Arias, please read. Ah, no, usted no le sirve el audio, dice no. Nicolás Chávez, lea la primera, por favor, sin la respuesta. Nicolás Chávez.
What do you not need to worry about? Leo las respuestas.
Estamos en literal C. ¿Sí está proyectándose la pantalla o donde usted?
No, listen, yo no veo la pantalla.
¿Los demás sí pueden ver la pantalla?
Sí.
Estamos ya en el literal C. Lea la primera.
Yo listen. La primera sería: Cold is muy the class party.
Ok, number two, Natasha Tinoco. Natasha Tinoco. Chao. Dina Tigja, number two.
The teacher are about the them because it is a European class.
Thank you. Isaac Franco, number three.
Sheoli thinks that college show. The dean to something like Napoleon or the AIDS.
For the AIDS. Sophie Tipan Luisa, number four, please. Sophie Tipan Luisa, number four. Fiorella Benalcázar, number four.
Most probably won't attend the party because it has but they usually return home before.
Thank you. Ana Puente, number five. Ana Puente, number five. Ana Puente, number five.
Should brother go there?
Melanie Salgado, number six.
Sally making of the students before making a decision.
Thank you. So please. Pay attention to the audio.
Hi, Caleb. You look busy. What are you doing?
I'm trying to plan the class party. I'm having doubts about the theme.
Oh, really? What is it?
It was to be a cowboy theme, but the teachers are uncertain about it.
Oh, yes. It is a European history class, after all. You should think about changing the theme. How about Napoleon or the Middle Ages?
Well, maybe. I'm also having reservations about how many people will come. It's on a bad date. Most students go home after the last classes before Christmas.
I'll be back home too, I'm afraid. It's on the 19th, right?
Yep. I'm unsure about the whole thing. I don't know if I should bother organizing anything at all.
I suggest that you ask who wants to come. Make a list of the students, then you can decide.
Good idea. I'll do that now.
Muy bien, chicos. Si es que necesitan escuchar de nuevo el audio, pues lo tienen ahí en el libro y lo pueden repetir.